Once upon a time, on the edge of a dark and dangerous jungle, a mighty hunter was returning to his family with a good day's catch of food. But as he came to the last large river he had to cross, he heard a small and agitated voice coming from the edge of the water.
Oh, no, I'm in big trouble now. Oh, I'm in really, really big trouble now. Oh, I'm never going to be able to do this. I'll never make it. I'll never be able to do this. Oh, no, no, no.
The hunter stopped, and there, fussing and fuming and practically chasing his tail as he paced back and forth along the shore, was a young and very proud-looking muskrat.
Yay-ho, young muskrat! What seems to be the matter?
The matter? The matter? Why, the rain is the matter, can't you see?
Rain? But it's not raining. Silly muskrat. If you want something to worry about, I suggest you try worrying about getting across this river. It's very wide and fast, and you look awfully small and scrawny to me.
But that's exactly what I'm talking about, the rain. See, the rains came this morning, and now the river has risen, and the water's too fast and way too deep, and I'm stuck here on the wrong side, and I can't get across, and I'll never get home, and now it's all because of that stupid rain.
Oh, now I understand. Well, good luck.
Hey, wait a minute. Where are you going? No, please come back. Look, please, maybe we can work out something here. Maybe we can work a deal, you know?
Oh, I'm sorry, but I have no time for deals. I have to get this food across the river to my family because we're all very hungry.
Yeah, well, look, I got a family too, you know, and they're waiting for me as well. They're probably worried and wondering where I am. Oh, come on, I'm a nice guy. You know, I don't deserve to be stuck on the riverbank like this. Come on, I gotta get home just like you.
But what could I do? If I was to take you across, I'd have to leave all this food over here, and another animal might come along and steal it. Besides, make me late for dinner and my wife would be very angry.
Well, hey, you telling me about wives? I got a wife, too, you know. She's already mad at me for something I did last week. If I come home late tonight, she won't tickle my whiskers for a month.
This really was a problem. If he helped the little muskrat, the hunter would be late and his family needed to eat. But if he didn't help the muskrat, the little animal would most certainly not get across the water. Poor hunter. Poor muskrat.
Hey, I tell you what. If you help me today, I promise to return the favor and help you someday. Hey, who knows? I might even save your life. Then we'd be all evened up. What do you say, huh?
You help me? How could you ever help me? You're just a scrawny...
Hey, watch that!
Oh, sorry, you're a tiny little muskrat. What's more, you're not even a smart muskrat. Look at yourself there, stuck here on the wrong side of the river. If I was to help you, how could I ever expect a tiny, little, unsmart muskrat to help me in return?
I don't know, but I promise that I will.
Well, what could the hunter do? So he laid down his heavy load of food, picked up the grateful little muskrat, and carried him across the water. The muskrat thanked him ever so much, and then hurried on his way, while the poor hunter then had to wade back across the river, pick up his food, and then recross it one more time before heading for home. And of course, just as expected, the extra trip made him very late. And when he told his wife why he was so late...
Muskrat, you made the children and me wait for our dinner so you could help a skinny little muskrat?
But, sweetheart, he promised to pay the favor back someday.
Oh, sure. That little rodent is really going to be able to help you. Oh, that's a good one. My husband, Mighty Hunter, and the biggest sucker of all time.
Well, a week or two went by, and soon the hunter had forgotten all about the muskrat and the promise he had made. For now it was time to hunt again. He took his faithful dog with him this time, but all they could catch were two small guinea hens. And what made it even worse, right in the middle of the afternoon, the skies opened up and it began to rain. It rained so hard that they had to seek shelter in a nearby cave. The cave was very dark and cold, so the hunter quickly built a fire and sat back with his dog to wait for the rain to stop. Everything was fine for about a minute or two, until suddenly, a mean and hungry lion entered the cave.
Huh? Excuse me, Mr. Lion, but I think we were here first.
Excuse me, Mr. Hunter, but I'm bigger than you.
And indeed, the lion was truly more than twice the poor hunter's size.
What I meant was, stay, yes,
stay and share our fire. In fact, would you like a nice guinea hen for a snack while you wait for the rain to stop?
No, thank you, Mr. Hunter. I don't want a small and puny guinea hen. In fact, why don't you feed those guinea hens to your dog?
My dog?
That's right. Let your dog eat the hens. You will eat the dog. And then I will eat you.
Me?
Who?
Well, of course you. You're the only thing in this cave worth eating.
Think again, Mr. Lion.
Who said that?
Yes, who said that?
I said that, and I too am very hungry.
But who are you? And why can't we see you?
You can't see me because I am too ugly and gruesome to be seen. The mere sight of me would frighten you to death.
Ha! Nothing frightens me. I'm the king of the jungle.
Maybe so, but I am the lord of this cave.
I'll tell you what then. We'll split him. The dog will eat the hens, and the man will eat the dog, and you and I will both eat the man. What do you say? What do you say?
I say, never mind, Mr. Lion. You eat the man all by yourself.
Really? Well, hey, thanks.
No problem. The dog will eat the hens, the man will eat the dog, and you will eat the man. And then I will eat you!
Say what?
Say, You look like a good one, too. Nice and fat and tasty.
You know, now that I think about it, I'm not really very hungry after all. And hey, look at that! The rain stopped. So I guess I'll just be leaving.
And with that, the lion leaped from the cave and ran away into the jungle. And now it was the hunter's turn to worry, for he and his dog were all alone in the cave with the mysterious beast. And just as he opened his mouth to beg for mercy...
Don't worry, I'm not really going to eat you.
Lo and behold, who should step out of the shadows but the muskrat?
You! I guess you won't be so quick to misjudge people next time, huh?
But, I mean, how?
It was easy. Watch this. I just lower my voice, you see, and then you talk into the cave walls and you let the echo do all the work.
My, you are a smart muskrat after all. And not only that, but you're a muskrat who keeps his word.
Hey, it's the only way to be.
And that is how a tiny little muskrat saved the life of a big, mighty hunter and taught the hunter a lesson. For you see, whether you're a man or a muskrat, you should always keep your promises. And it always pays to help a friend when you can.